Hey friends, Joshua14 back with another Gaming on the Surface Pro 8 video. This is Crusader Kings 3, running on the i7 model with 16 gigs of RAM, 256 SSD. And I have no idea what I'm doing, but I'm going through the tutorial right now, learning about all the traits of my character. Right now I have it set. Gold resources, of course. Money can't buy everything. Prestige, piety. Lifestyle button. Diplomacy, stewardship, martial, intrigue, learning. Click on your player heirs character. Right click. Send gift. Alright. Let me show you the settings really quick. Full screen, full res, 2880 by 1920 with VSync on. I just set the quality preset for low and let the rest do the rest. So all these are unchecked. Dynamic coastal borders, maximum FPS I'm gonna put for 120. Don't think we'll get there, but we'll see what happens. And if you do not have an heir for your own dynasty, realm on the right side of the screen highlighted. Inspect the succession tab. Alright. I understand. Click on your character. Continue unmarried. Select marriages. Right clicking. Choose find spouse. There we go. Alliance, Prince Bledin Ap Sinfin of Gwynedd. Excellent. Find one for my son as well. Change the Duchy Tettles map mode. Return to realms. Wow. Oh, here we go. Duchy Tettles. There we go. And the realms map mode. All right. Bastions and Curtain Walls. Okay. 3 years left. Open the realm view, the right side of the screen. Inspect the vassals tab. Oh, here we go. Vassals. I can have 20 vassals, not bad. All right. Intrigue view. Schemes. Intrigue. Murder schemes. Council view, right click on your court chaplain, that's the bishop, okay, choose sway, okay, open the intrigue, and there he goes, that's with hooks and secrets. Okay, hooks you hold. Alright. So it looks like we're able to maintain around 50 frames per second, which in a game like this, where not a lot's going on, at least I don't think it's going to go on. Open the military view. Let me see now. That's going to be it. Rally points. Pause the game. Spacebar. Or click the play button. Declare war on the Earl Murdiac of Desmond. Declare war. All right. Let's see what happens. Raise your armies. Raise all armies. Moving to battle, we'll start siege. I hope he becomes my vassal. War started 3 months ago. Wow. I'm not surrendering. Okay, so it's almost gaining strength. Hopefully they have 6 knights and they have only 5 knights left. Sure if there's any way to speed this up or not. Oh, there we go. Click to change. Slowest. Fast. There we go. Let's do fastest. Okay, well, looks like it's chugging along here. Still around 50 FPS, 40 FPS. It's going up and down. I'm gonna zoom out. Still able to handle even 60 FPS, 50 FPS. So, all right, okay. Our army is attacking enemy holding. Click the highlighted icon, spearheads, to find out how it's going. Go. Siege is won. Occupied. Score, you can force the other side to accept your peace officer. Peace offer. Okay, so I need plus 100. Okay. Alright, I know this was just the tutorial, but let me see if I can get any better results out of switching it to basically my go-to 1440 by 960. Oh yeah, able to get 100. Well, it was 100. So yeah, still crisp, but better result. Still at low settings, so you'll definitely be able to play around a little bit better with this. So still 27. So, all right. Well, it's all over the FPS is all over the place, but you get the idea. Definitely can play Crusader Kings 3. And this is an Xbox Game Pass title, which I'm running it off of. But I'd never run any of the Crusaders games before. And looks like able to do it just fine here on the Surface Pro 8 i7 with 16 gigs of RAM. And I hope you all enjoyed. We will catch you in the next one. Take care.